Hello everyone, welcome to and welcome back to my channel, Book Time with Elvis, with me, Mark. And Elvis is around here somewhere. You'll probably see him at some point running in the background. It's been a while. Yeah, I haven't, I've been quite busy, haven't been able to make any videos. I've kept doing the lives, but I haven't made a video, I think, for a couple of weeks. And don't worry, the peeps at many lands will be back, because I know a lot of you are missing that, of course. But it will be back, I hope sometime over the weekend. I have a long weekend here, so that's a positive. I should get things done. Anyway, this is just a quick video, really, to give you my provisional TBR for the month of February, which has approached us so quickly. I can't believe already it's the first. I'm only going through the books that I've got physical copies of. I will be taking part in the read-alongs hosted by Mark Richardson at Richardson Reads, which is for what's it called, the Sackett series, that's right. And also Mark hosts with Faith and Books, Faith from Faith and Books, the Hornblower series. So I'll be reading in both those series book two during the month of February. Now before I can really embark on my February TBR, a book, well, there are a couple of books from January carrying over. One's going to carry on throughout the entire year, and the other one, I hope, will carry on just for another week or so, maybe. And that is Les Miserables by Victor Hugo. It's the Christine Donoher translation, Donoher, however you want to say it, I suppose. And it's absolutely wonderful. If you watched my esteemed colleagues Sean D. Standfast's video earlier on today, he talks about it in great detail because he's finished it. I haven't, but as you can see, I haven't got too much farther to go. I'm doing this with a group read, buddy read of three of us, myself, Summer from Sterling Reads, and Sonia Deveni, who's a beloved subscriber to our channels. And we're all thoroughly enjoying it. I would say we're enraptured by it, really. It's, you know, I haven't finished it yet, and it's already probably one of the greatest books I've ever read, and I would say it's one of the greatest books probably ever written. However, of course, I haven't been able to read it in French, but thoroughly enjoying it, and I will talk more about it once I've finished that. It's, you know, it's a hard thing, because I want to finish it, to see what happens, but I know I also don't want it to end. I've been enjoying it that much. You know, I'm going to feel a sense of loss once this is over with. And the other one's a big one that I'm continuing and will probably appear on every TBR, because, as I say, it's taking place throughout the course of the entire year, and that's The World, A Family History by Simon Sebag Montefiore. And I'm reading it as part of the Historathon 2023 event hosted by Finn at Revenant Reads, as well as a host of other wonderful co-hosts. And the reason why, it's a history of the world, and it starts from ancient times up until, I think, pretty much the present day. So I'm taking it kind of different parts at a time, and I've only read part one of this, and so far it's very good. It's a series of sketches, vignettes, if you like, or short stories, essays on different people and their dynasties or families, and how they work into the history or world history. And yeah, it's pretty good so far. I'm enjoying that. And as if I didn't have enough on, I decided to take part in Michael K. Vaughan's, or Rogers, I should say, cheap old book club that's running at Michael K. Vaughan's channel. The read for February is Anthony Hope's The Prisoner of Zenda. It's a book I very much enjoy, and I, you know, looking forward to for an excuse to read it again. I did mention it back in August of Adventures as a recommendation if people wanted to read it then. So I'm going to read that. It won't take very long. I mean, it won't take that long, will it? So yeah, I think that will be good fun. And if I have time, I've still got a few more to get through, I may try on the sequel, Rupert of Hentzau. So I haven't read this one before. I haven't read the prequel either, but I don't have that. So, you know, I think that's enough to be going on with at the moment. And if you're aware or not, part of the reason I've been reading Les Miserables, because I set myself the challenge to read 12 classic French works, classic literary works, throughout the course of the year, one a month. Now, as you've seen, Les Miserables is going to carry on through into part of February, but February's choice or pick is Voltaire's Candide, and I've got it here with a collection of other stories. One of them is Micromegas, but I read that actually for New World's November back in November, so I will probably skip that. I mean, it's not very long. I mean, Candide itself is only 88 pages, and Micromegas is, I don't know, probably like 10 maybe. But I'll probably check out the other stories in this book as well. I've already made a little start because I'm having to wait a little bit in Les Mis for people to catch up. There's no problem with that. And yeah, so far I'm pretty impressed actually. It seems quite funny. So yeah, I'm looking forward to discovering Voltaire. And Sean D. Standfast is along for the ride on this one, as I think he will be for most of my foray into French literature. Seeing as he's somewhat of a, what's the word, connoisseur of the genre, I suppose. So yeah, and speaking of Mr. Sean D. Standfast, Canada's premier poet, I have his book, Dark Passages, Moments in Transition, and it's also on my TBR that I hope to get to in February. Now, February is a short month. Quite a lot going on, and I'm sure Sean will forgive me if I don't go through the whole thing within the time, but I shall certainly make a start on it. I've read a few of the poems in here, like just as I flipped through and had a look at some of them, but it would be nice to go through it, I think, in one go, given the idea of a passage, I suppose. You know, maybe it should be read in one block, but I look forward very much to do that. And of course, you know, if you know Sean D. Standfast, check out his book, why not? Help a guy out. next up, I'm reading with Vin from Revenant Reads and Stephanie Cohen, one of our subscribers. We've been reading works or ancient works. We've done, what have we done? We did Herodotus, but I don't know if that's, if this is a continuation of that or not. But we did Thucydides anyway last year. And I think we all read through the Landmark edition of that. And I know those two are enamored with them, the Landmark editions. I don't know, I've gone a bit old school. So we got the Helicron, is it? Or Hellenica? And the Anabasis or Anabasis. And we've decided to read both of them. Now I've gone old school with the Penguin Classics. So this is the Persian Expedition, which is... the Persian Expedition is the Anabasis, probably. Yeah, I think this is the Anabasis. So that would be fun, and it's not too bad. I think it's quite daunting in the Landmark edition because it's so big, hardback books, but, you know, in the Penguin, yeah, there are a lot of notes. Okay, it's short on maps, but, you know, I know where the places are. Maybe. And then the Hellenica, or... Helicron, is it? Hellenica is in the Penguin edition is known as A History of My Times by Xenophon. And as I say, we're going to read both of those. I don't know if we're going to try and get them both done during the month of February, but certainly we can carry on through to March. I don't see any problem with that. Of course, these two will be part of Historathon, the event that Vin is hosting, which I'm lucky enough to be co-host, and through the months of January, February, and March, we are looking at Prehistory to 500 AD, so they both slot in there very nicely. Something else that slots in that I plan to read during February is Pliny the Younger's Complete Letters, and I believe Sean D. Standfast is going to read it as well, so I didn't know that. I only saw that on his... video earlier, and I'd also plan to read it, so I guess we'll probably compare notes on Pliny's letters, so I think that would be good fun. And lastly, yes, there is more, can you believe it? It's a short month as well, but there is more, and that is I am going to read with a friend of mine John Steinbeck's travels with Charlie in search of America. And I think that would be nice, about Steinbeck traveling through different parts of the United States with his dog, Charlie. So that would be wonderful, I think. I like stories, especially when I know that the dog's all right, you know, not, that nothing's going to happen to them. So at least hopefully not. I'll be rather upset if it does, but hey ho. So that's my provisional list of books to read for February. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you're reading, of course, in the comments below. And if you know, I'm always open to buddy reads and things. So if you want to read something and you want someone to read it with, leave a comment below and we'll schedule a time when we can read it together. So take care, everybody. Have a great day, and I will be back soon, I hope, with more videos. Take care. Bye bye.